In this video, I'll show you shortcuts that I use in DaVinci Resolve. In the description below, you can find a link to my keyboard layout, to all of my shortcuts, which you can upload to DaVinci and test it. I use Windows system, so this tutorial is related to Windows keyboard, but you can easily convert it to Mac. Using shortcuts is effective when you do it frequently. It's based on memory muscle, so you need to train it to be efficient. This video is comprehensive. For some viewers, it can be boring, but if you really want to improve your workflow, it will be valuable for you. Before I start, I show you how to upload my keyboard layout. To do that, hold Ctrl Alt K, and you've got these three dots here. So go there, click Import Preset, and go to the location where you download the file. So I have it, for example, here. That will be this file. Click Open, and now you need to select this Addictive Frames keyboard. Okay, firstly, I show you which shortcuts I use for playback. For this purpose, I use only these three keyboards, which is 1, 2, 3. So it's simple. To move forward, I use number 3. To pause my video, I use number 2. To move backward, I use number 1. And if I want to move every frame, so I need to hold 2 and type 3. And my playhead move every frame. Same as backward, I hold 2. And type 1. I could use arrow on my keyboard to move every frame forward. I would use this arrow and this arrow to move left every frame. But I want to stick my hand, my round hand, to my mouse as much as possible and keep my left hand here in this area on keyboard. Now, if I would like to play my clip faster, so let's say if I want to play with double speed, so I need to type twice number 3. So we got 2 times fast, again 4 times, 8 times, 16 times, 32 and 64, and we can't do anymore. Now, if I want to jump between clips without moving my mouse like that, what I can do, I can hold Alt and type Z, and I'm jumping same as to the right side, hold Alt and type C. And this is my shortcut for that. Now I show you what I do to effectively and quickly cut my A roll. So for that purpose, I'm gonna jump to trim mode, typing T. If I'd like to jump back, I type A, but let's go back to trim mode. Before I even start cutting, I want to make sure that every clip is selected and follow my playhead. For this purpose, I use selection follow playhead, and I have shortcut for that, which is Shift Q. And now, as you can see, when my playhead is here, the clip is selected as well. It helps me to see where I am on my timeline right now. To effectively and quickly cut my A roll, I mainly use Q, W and E. And let's say I want to remove this silent part at the end. What I need to do, I need to just type E and jump down. And now what I do to remove the other silent parts, I need to just type W. And now I'm typing Q and it's jump down. And same as here. And done. And now let's say for some reason I want to remove this clip. What I do, I need to just hold Ctrl and type S and it's ripple deleted. And now imagine that these clips are not together and this is my whole timeline. And for some reason I would like to join them together. So I need to just type Escape. Let's select the timeline and Escape. And they're all together now. And now I show you how to navigate in media pool window, which is here. So let's say I want to drop some B-roll on my A-roll. Let's say that one. So I'm playing back, let's say forward here, and I'm happy from this point, I would like to cut. So I type F2 and moving forward. Okay, I'm happy with this clip. And to cut it out, I type F3. And I just grab it to there. Timeline. And now imagine that I have some speech to cut in my media pool window. So let's say this one, and it would be great if I have some audio information at the bottom. For that purpose, I need to type A, and I've got my all audio waveform at the bottom. And if I would like to look closer, or let's say this part of the audio, I need to hold Ctrl and type A. and this audio waveform is zoomed. And now I show you what I do to move my clips on the timeline. So let's say I want to move up, and to do that I need to hold Alt and type arrow up. That's the same down. And if I would like to move this clip left or right without using mouse, so I need to type this arrow, and it's moving every frame. If I would like to move it every second, so I need to hold shift and type this arrow same to the left. And if for some reason I would like to copy this clip, I need to hold Alt and mouse left button and just move it. And now I show you how to swap between clips. So imagine that you need to swap this clip with this. It's very simple. What you need to do is just select this clip, hold Ctrl Shift, and this arrow, and clips are swapped. And if you want to do opposite way, so you need to do the same, Ctrl Shift, and just type this arrow. And I will show you how to select all the clips on timeline from some point. So let's say I want to select all of the timeline from this point to the right, and I would like to insert some clip here. So to do that, I need to hold Alt and type Y, and all my timeline is selected on the right side, as you can see. And let's say I need to move it, and I need to insert some of this clip, and to go back and to just type S and drop down. Lastly, I would like to show you what keyboard shortcuts I use to drop markers on my timeline. And instead of clicking here, I type F1 and I have marker here. If I would like to drop marker here with some information, I need to type twice F1. And I have this window, and I can drop some information. I can change the colors, and I can even change length of this marker. So let's say 5 frames. And now I can stretch this out. And I know from this point, I need to do something. This is for me, right? Like a reminder. I show you just few main keyboard shortcuts that I use very often. If you'd like to see the rest of them, just type Ctrl Alt key. And if you have Addictive Frames keyboard here, so then you go to application or edit, and you have all keyboard shortcuts I use in edit page. If you'd like to see which keyboard shortcuts are set up for trim mode, go to trim mode and see here, and so on and so forth. Okay, these shortcuts are my personal preferences. It works for me, but it doesn't have to be convenient to everyone. So download it and test it and find if they're right for you. And please let me know in the comment below how do you like it. Also, I dropped notebook file with list of my main shortcuts. You can use it as a guide for this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.